আসসালামু আলাইকুম প্রিয় শিক্ষার্থীবৃন্দ, শুভ সকাল। কেমন আছো তোমরা? আশা করি সবাই ভালো আছো। আজকে তোমাদের সঙ্গে আছি আমি প্রফেসর ডাক্তার শামিমা সুরাইয়া বেগম, বিভাগীয় প্রধান কমিউনিটি মেডিসিন বিভাগ, বসুন্ধরা আদ্দিন মেডিকেল কলেজ। ডিয়ার স্টুডেন্টস, টুডে আই উইল ডিসকাস অন ডিনামিক্স অফ ডিজিজ ট্রান্সমিশনস। থ্রি থিংস আর ইম্পর্টেন্ট ফর ডিজিজ কজিশন: নাম্বার ওয়ান এজেন্ট, নাম্বার টু হোস্ট, অ্যান্ড নাম্বার থ্রি এনভায়রনমেন্ট। These three things are together called epidemiological triad. What is agent? Agent may be defined as a substance, living or non-living, or a force, tangible or intangible, the excessive presence or relative lack of which may initiate or perpetuate a disease process. Agent may be classified into different groups. Number one, biological agents. Biological agents are bacteria, virus, rickettsia, protozoa, metazoa, etc. Chemical agents. Chemical agents are two types: endogenous agents and exogenous agents. Endogenous agents are urea, uric acid, serum bilirubin, ketone bodies, calcium carbonate, etc. And exogenous agents are allergens, metal, dust, fumes, gases, and insecticides, etc. Then physical agents. Physical agents are heat, cold, pressure, humidity, radiation, electricity, sound, etc. Then nutritional agents. Nutritional agents are protein, fat, carbohydrate, vitamin, minerals, and water. Any excess or deficiency of the intake of nutritive elements may result in nutritional disorders. As for example, protein energy malnutrition, anemia, goiter, obesity, vitamin deficiency, etc. And then mechanical agents. Mechanical agents are trauma, chronic friction, crushing, tearing, sprain, etc. Number two is the host factor. Host factor may be classified as demographic characteristics. The demographic characteristics are the age, sex, ethnicity. Then biological characteristics. Biological characteristics are genetic factors, biochemical levels of the blood, blood groups and enzymes, cellular constitution of the blood, immunological factors and physiological function of the different organ systems of the body, that is blood pressure, forced expiratory expression, etc. Third one is the social and economic characteristics. Social and economic characteristics are socio-economic status, that is income, education, occupation, marital status and housing. And last one is the lifestyle factors. Lifestyle factors includes personality, habits, physical exercise, use of alcohol and drugs, and smoking. Third one is the environment, which is most important. Environment is three types: physical environment, biological environment and psychosocial environment. Physical environment include air, water, soil, housing, climate, heat, light, noise, radiation, etc. Biological environment. Biological environment includes the living things of the virus and the microbial agents, insects, rodents, animal, plants, etc. And psychosocial environment includes cultural values, customs, habits, belief, attitudes and moral, etc. Dear students, now I will discuss on chain of infection. Chain of infection includes agent, then source or reservoir, portal of exits, mode of transmission, portal of entry and susceptible host. Agent already I have discussed. Now what is reservoir? Reservoir is the site of infection where the organism resides, metabolizes and multiplies. And the source? Source is the site from which the organism transmitted to the susceptible host, either directly or indirectly through an intermediary objects. Then portal of exits. Portal of exit includes respiratory tract, gastrointestinal tract, genitourinary tract and open lesion. And then mode of transmission. There are two type of mode of transmission. Number one, direct transmission. Number two, indirect transmission. Direct transmission includes person-to-person contact, then droplet infection, then direct exposure to susceptible host, and inoculation into skin and bite of animals. Indirect transmission includes vehicle-borne, then vector-borne, then airborne, then fomite-borne. There are several diseases occurs due to indirect transmissions. The diseases are diarrheal disease, typhoid, food poisoning, hepatitis A, tuberculosis, dysentery, malaria, filaria, respiratory tract infection, mumps, measles, etc. The last one, but the not least, the investigation of the disease. For disease investigation, there are several steps. Number one, establishment of diagnosis. Number two, identify a specific agent. Number three, describe according to person, place and time. Number four, identify source of agent. Number six, identify mode of transmission. And number seven, identify susceptible host. That's all for today. Thank you all. Thank you very much.